What's going on, guys? I wanted to make a quick video as a follow-up to a post I had put on YouTube last night in reference to the firmware that I've been running on the Vegas Bando. So if you didn't already know, I've been running Betaflight 4.3 on this quad for months, even way before Release Candidate 1 came out. But I haven't done or changed anything. I finally got a chance today to actually do some tuning, and it's even flying even better. And I'm hoping to get a chance to maybe go flying tomorrow and do like a nice actual demonstration of what it's like with this new firmware with a nice good proper tune. But I went ahead and put the firmware on there a few days ago, and I went and just blasted around, because the new feature that you get with BL Heli 32's new pre-release firmware is what's called BiRPM as a selection option in your PWM frequency choices. So if you didn't already know, BL Heli 32 already had variable frequency with 32.8, but it was kind of gimmicky and I didn't really like the way it felt, and I always just locked myself into 48 kilohertz on low and high. But now with this new feature, you can get as low on the low side as 16 kilohertz, and as on the high side, you can go all the way up to what's called BiRPM. And it is a great complement to Betaflight 4.3, specifically Release Candidate 3. And if you didn't really know as well, Betaflight 4.3 Release Candidate 3 actually introduces some changes to the way how TPA works. It feels a lot more fluid and just straightforward rather than kind of steppy feeling. And if you don't know what TPA is, basically it has to do with how your PIDs are reacting at particular throttle levels. So I used to like to get as high as I could without getting, you know, oscillations and things like that in my TPA, but now with the things that have been changing and the firmwares and all that stuff, we're able to kind of get more of our efficiency back on the ESC side. We don't have to go so hard on the TPA side, so I did make some changes. I'll go ahead and show you the settings that I'm rocking now as far as BL Heli 32 and Betaflight 4.3 as a quick, like, hey, this is what I'm using. If you have any questions, please drop them in the comments below. And it's been pretty awesome so far, especially now that I've actually got a chance to tune it today. Oh man, this quad is flying smooth. And I plan on, like I said, doing some justice to it. Probably tomorrow, hopefully, I'll go do some flying and stuff like that. All right, so real quick with my Betaflight settings, I'm gonna go over, this is my new PID tune that I'm using for this particular drone. This is, again, the Spando. Big reason why you're seeing more than just what the defaults would normally have is because it is a bit of a heavy drone in the pitch axis, especially because I use a full-size GoPro on this thing. So I tend to kind of have to compensate that on the pitch axis more. And this is basically where I end up sticking with the way that I like the way my PIDs feel. Most of the time, you won't even have to go into this great detail with your drone at all. If you're somebody who don't normally fly like a heavier drone, or you're just using like a Session 5 or a Pinion or whatever, you can pretty much just stick with the defaults all the way down. Don't use dynamic dampening, it's trash. But stick with the defaults all the way down, put dynamic dampening at zero, and then just manipulate your master multiplier on its own, and it'll pretty much handle all your tuning processes there. The thing that I did try all day today, I've got a lot of people who always say, like, don't use thrust centralization, it doesn't do anything, it serves no purpose, and I tried so hard. I flew like 4 or 5 packs a day without it, and there was just something, I just couldn't put my finger on it. And as soon as I turned it on, and I always use 25% if I'm gonna do it, it just felt good again. So I was like, you know what, I'm gonna stick with that, and that's why I've got thrust centralization on. I use dynamic idle value with this particular drone because I do use quite pitchy props. They're not super pitchy, but they're about 4.35, and they're shorter, they're 4.9. So I like the feeling of having dynamic idle value on, and when I do it, because of the pitchiness of these props, I do it at about 35. I can get away with 30, but I just like the way 35 feels a little bit better. My overall hang time with this drone, it's got so much momentum, the hang time is, I get great hang time, I'm not worried about it. But, so yeah, that's where I'm gonna stick with 35 there. If you're flying something that has nothing, you know, props that aren't as pitchy, like let's say you're using like some PB&J ethics props or something, you could probably go as low as 20, maybe 25. But what you're trying to avoid is desyncing. If you're going too low, you may get desyncs. So just look out for that. If you're testing this kind of stuff, always do it over some nice soft grass. Don't, you know, do this kind of stuff where you could possibly hurt yourself or the drone or anybody else. So yeah, that's for that. Moving on to the next tab, we're on a rate profile tab. I have now been able to change, because of the changes in 4.3, Release Candidate 3, my TPA breakpoint used to be at 0.75 and I would run 1750. I kind of was doing it sort of because it was making up for the loss of ramp-up power that we used to do in BL Heli, but now that that's not a thing anymore, I can actually bump my TPA back down, and it feels nice and smooth now with the way that they've made the changes to it as well. And this is actually feeling really solid right now. So I believe 0.65 is default, at least for this flight controller. And I think 1350 is the breakpoint normally, but I bump it up to 1650. because I want to get my PID gains going as high as I can in the throttle before I start hearing, you know, trilling and oscillation and stuff. So that's something I've kind of been doing for a while, and I like the way it feels. In the filter settings tab, now this drone is quite nice. It actually has very low resonance. There's not a lot of stuff going on as far as noise in this drone. I have one issue with a frame resonance roughly at about 240 hertz, and I essentially can take care of that with just my one dynamic notch. Outside of that, I was previously using the defaults for the dynamic notch, but after looking at my filters today, I'm actually able to bump that down, the max of it down to 500. I kept the minimum where it is. I'm always using my RPM filters. I don't use gyro low pass filters. This drone does not need it. Most drones don't need it unless you have a lot of mechanical issues, I would say. And I keep my yaw low pass filter on. This was a recommendation I got from Mouse. And I think it's a good recommendation because this isn't particularly a really like intensive filter in regards to how the flight controller is processing it and everything else it's trying to do. He said, you know, why not just try leaving it on? I've heard it from a couple of people, so I have been leaving it on, and it really doesn't seem to make much of a difference whether it's on or off, so it's on. And then my D-term low pass, I am getting a little bit of noise that I wasn't getting prior, kind of going closer to the lower end of the D-term. So I did actually bump it down 0.5. I usually just leave it at default at 1, and because of all the nice changes in 4.3, like, these things really aren't making too much of a difference on your overall feel of your tune, so on and so forth. It still gets great prop wash performance, and overall the feeling is still really nice. So I did end up doing that to take care of a little bit of the noise that was coming in prior to what I previously had it. But those are my filter settings. And then lastly, we're going to hop into BL Heli 32, and this is what I'm now using. So if you notice, I'm using the beta version 32.83. Again, links in the description below of how to put this on your quad if you want to try it. And now, because everything is a lot more efficient and it's running a lot smoother now, so on and so forth, a lot of this stuff is described in Chris Rosser's video, which I'll also link below, so please check that out if you want to get like a full understanding of everything. We are now back up to 50% ramp up power, which is awesome. So before, we used to go down as low as like 30. I usually kind of sat around 40%, and the 50 has been feeling pretty great on this. So I'm liking that we're kind of getting back up there again. My motor timing is gonna stay at 23. He actually recommended, Chris Rosser recommended, going down to 16 degrees. And as much as I want to say, you know, it's probably great for certain people, this drone is a little heavy, and again, it's pitchy and all that stuff like that. So I like the feeling of 23. It's more, for me, it's more secure as far as desync management and all that whatnot. I don't want to desync, so I'm going to leave it at 23. It still feels good, and it's still a pretty good efficient motor timing to use. The big thing here, though, is PWM frequency low. We're now going down to 16 kilohertz, and for high, we're going by RPM. And this is really the bread and butter of this new firmware that we're using, BL Heli 32. This feeling that you get is just something like, I don't know how to describe it other than just a lot of power when you want it and a nice smooth buttery feel when you want it, and it's just best of both worlds all the time. So this is an awesome feature, something you definitely should check out if you're going to want to give this a try. Set this up and see if it's working for you. If you happen to have a ESC that can go as far as up to 128. I've heard a couple of people say that they've tried by RPM on it, but it kind of was getting a little bit of issues at 128. It kind of sort of depends probably on the weight of your drone and the KV of your motors and all that stuff like that. Like, these are slightly higher KV motors than I believe Chris Rosser may have used on 6S, and you know, I use some pretty high discharge batteries, so you know, maybe for certain people it might be great, maybe other people it's not so great. So just be cautious. Again, if you're gonna test this stuff, do it over some nice soft grass and try not to bash your drone or your face or anything like that. So yeah, give these things a shot. And with that said, I'm gonna show you guys a video of just me fucking ripping around and having a blast with these new settings and the new firmware.